Welcome to this module 36 on manufacturing systems technology. So we were talking in great details about the fixed sequential format, and we also knew how, you know, there can be a drilling operation which can be simulated or which can be mentioned in terms of three blocks or three statements using several words. Some of the words are indexing numbers, some of the words are related to whether it is linearly or rapidly able to position, some of the words are related to the XYZ dimensions or coordinates, some of the words are related to the feed rate of the drill, and some of the words are related to the end conditions, for example, is the coolant on or coolant off or so on and so forth. So it was a very simple progression of a sequence of commands which was given in terms of numbers, where now the understanding of the controller already will be in terms of those numbers, and it will also interpret everything in the absolute manner starting from the origin, so that it can do this job by sending the right amount of current signals to the different drives which are holding, for example, the tool or for example the workpiece, and left alone to it, it will do some optimization to calculate whether it is the tool which is going to move or the workpiece. But you are actually programming always as the drill tip or the tool. Okay, so we are following whatever syntax we have actually laid down earlier. Okay, in this particular method. What are the problems associated with the fixed sequential format? And that gives you a basis of the tab sequential format. So this is how the tab sequential format actually looks into. So if you look at, let's say, this particular illustration here, this actually gives you the tab sequential format. And you know, if I look at one of the problems related to its predecessor, that is the fixed sequential format, it is in terms of repeatability of the different materials or the different, you know, numbers. For example, let's look at this particular slide here, which talks about the initial basic, okay, about the fixed sequential format. So if I closely look at it, these numbers here, for example, the 01 number on block 2 and 01 number on block 3 are repeating. The 0025400 number is repeating every time. The 00125001250, these are also repeating every time. Similarly, the number 500 is repeating every time. So therefore, when you are talking about a manual punching system for a programmer, every time you have to take a command, without taking it from the last line, you are actually inputting the command yourself in the next line again, and you are typing again and again. So it's definitely something which is not a very handy thing. It's probably a time consuming affair, and it is not a very productive way of doing the programming. And if instead of this, we could actually convert this whole data as rows and columns, let's say there are certain, you know, classifications that you have provided. So this is corresponding to the first row, second row and third row, okay, in this particular manner. And for example, this is corresponding to first, second, third, fourth, all the way to seventh column. So the data here is really given as a column address and a row address, okay. So you have a one row and one column address here, one row and two column address here. Similarly, one row and three column address here, one row and four column. Similarly, three row and four column address here. So there is some kind of a matrix form in which this data has been laid out. So it is very convenient for an operator to, you know, to assume that if there is a button which allows you to just by a hit of button, okay, and two buttons, let's say there is a tab button which is very common to all the computers, okay. So by the allowance of that tab button, if I can just fix this particular value to 0025400, all I need to do in the second line and the third line is to press tab two times, so that this value can be automatically taken from the last column and row address, okay. So you need not specifically write the 0025400 here, you can just rather press tab here and tab here, so that the value is automatically repeated. Similarly, tab here and the value is automatically repeated. Okay, so this is a change in technology which happened, and the programming and the controllers were started to develop in that manner, which led to the development of the tab sequential format. Here, for example, you can see that, you know, once you have given a value between two tab options, you need not repeat this anymore. So between the first and second tab, automatically this value will be taken. Between the third and the the second and the third tab, automatically this other value will be taken, and you just stop writing the values in a repetitive manner between the different blocks or different statements. So definitely this was an improvement in terms of productively being able to write a program, and it was really a good improvement on the fixed sequential format, as you can see. Okay, so format is essentially the same, that meaning thereby the sequence of the index number, the rapid positioning number, the XYZ coordinates, you know, the other details related to the starting of the feed or stopping of the feed, or for example even the coolant on, coolant off, that sequence will not change of the commands, but only thing that you are changing here is utilization of the tab allows that you are repeating the values automatically, or taking the values automatically from the last line when it involves a repetition of the value. Okay, so you are saving on the programmer's time this way. So tab character indicates the beginning of a new word, but does not specify which type of the word. Therefore, the sequence of the word remains significant from between the different rows. So that's the tab sequential format. Finally, another opinion that was expressed by many people is that, you know, when you're talking about these numbers, really for a person who is looking into a 360,000 lines of programs, okay, it is very inconvenient at the end of the day to keep a tally on what follows what, you know, unless you have every time you're comparing the sequence and trying to see what sequence is corresponding to, or what is the really the title of this column, or the title of this particular column, or this column, you're not able to compare every time, and every time you have to really count, you know, from the left to right to identify which column, which row, and try to then see what is that function for. For example, 00 is for the rapid positioning, which is corresponding to row 1 and column 2. Okay. So this row 1 and column 2 would be same throughout, but supposing there was something corresponding to row 1 and column, let's say 20, okay, something like that, or maybe row 1 and column 15. So it is very difficult to identify that in a list of such sequences if you do not have a title for every page as a header title for the particular column. Okay, so therefore it was, you know, argued upon that why the controller should not be able to understand a certain basic English words. Okay, and obviously the controller capability changed a lot during the I would say the late 70s or in the beginning of even 80s and all. And so there was a substantial amount of technological improvement in the way that controllers are designed or specified. And so it emerged into what is called the current day format, which is also known as the word sequential format, okay, which is the probably the newest format that has evolved in the whole NC programming system. So here you have a word, as you can see, associated with a certain syntax number which has been given. For example, there is a word N associated, indicating that this is probably the index number. So N50 means the 50th line of the program, N60 means the 60th line of the program, N70 means the 70th line of the program, so on and so forth. Similarly, you have a set of commands which have evolved, which are also known as the G commands, which would really process the controller to do a certain statement. For example, in this block 1 and block 2, you have two different G commands, G00 and G01. So this corresponds to your rapid positioning earlier, that I had actually illustrated to you what exactly rapid positioning is. And this corresponds to your linear positioning or linear feed. Okay, so linear positioning. So these two G commands, which are also known as preparatory commands, allows the controller now and presets the controller to carry out a certain operation in a certain manner. Okay, so that's how this is done. Obviously, the X, Y, and Z numbers associated with them indicate the readouts in the, you know, in terms of the number of coordinates. Here, of course, you can see that X 25400 has been written, meaning thereby this corresponds to 25.4 mm. So this controller is probably capable of reading between 99.999. to 00.000, about close to about 100,000 values, you know, in between. Okay, and similarly the way that you have defined the Y and Z also remains more or less the same. You have also associated the word feed F from the word feed with respect to this number of 500 millimeter per minute, which was actually the feed rate of the drilling tip that was being programmed in this way. And then, so this is called the feed command. So you'll obviously have also a speed and a speed command for defining the RPM, because later on, you know, drilling was no longer done at a constant you know, RPM in the interest of machining optimizations, because obviously it is also a scribing process and there has to be a sort of optimum cutting rate which is a function of the drill speed as well. Okay, so you have different variabilities in the drill spade introduced into the NC system to have optimization of the cutting tip, because cutting tip is very expensive. Okay, and you have to create a situation where that tip without changing can do multiple turning operations. Okay, so therefore there was a speed command also associated with the whole the NC programming system, and then obviously this whole coolant business, coolant start and stop, and these are some of the miscellaneous functions. For example, you can clamp or declamp a workpiece, or coolant can be started off or on at certain point, which are really the miscellaneous functions associated with the machining, but not really actively involved as a working participant for the machining process. So these are now classified as a miscellaneous command, and so the word M comes out of there, and there is an index now related to M1, M2, M3, so on up to probably M30 or M40. There are many such miscellaneous commands which are available as index in the program. So you can see the same three blocks have been written in the word sequential format in a manner now that I can probably go to this row and this column and understand what this element is. So for example, this corresponds to M09, which means that the coolant should stop. This corresponds to Z0, meaning thereby that the Z has gone to the position coordinate before. What is also important for me to tell you is that this word address format has also been designed keeping in the tab option available. So every time you need not write the X and Y, once you have written the X and Y, it automatically gets translated, and only thing which changes is the Z value. From 0 you have changed to minus 10, that means the drill has moved into the block at 10 mm, and then again you are going back to the Z0, so therefore it is retranslating back to the Z0 option. And this whole thing is what in a very convenient and consolidated manner you can look into, and at every spot you can identify what a particular number or a particular command would be using or would be used there for. Okay, so this is what the latest development is in this area, and this is also known as the word sequential format. Let us now come to a little more details about the different preparatory functions, the miscellaneous functions, or for example, how do you lay out the XYZ data in such a controller design. And the first thing that comes to our mind is that, you know, there are many such commonly used words in the word addresses format. There can be a feed rate command given by F, there can be a preparatory function command, and there are many such G commands varying between G01 to almost G99, about 100 or so, which have been probably developed for different controllers which have different capabilities. So it actually prepares, as you have already seen, the controller to do some, carry out some particular job. Then there are commands related to circular interpolation in the X axis, Y axis and Z axis. I'm going to in detail explain about what these circular interpolations mean. So IJK corresponding to XYZ. There are miscellaneous commands like you saw in the case of coolant earlier. And obviously the sequence number command or the identification number N, which is there. And then there can be various other commands like the arc radius, the spindle speed, the tool number, the X, Y and Z data on the axis, which can be repeated, which need not be repeated once it has been into the block, unless there is a change. They can be treated as a modal command and it will keep on taking those values between the different lines of the block. So in a way, that's how the whole word sequential format has evolved, and now you have pretty much everything mentioned in place about the different words. So let's now probably close the topic right now for discussion, and in the next session I would like to actually continue this further and talk about a basic international coding standard, also known as the American National Standards Institute, ANSI, based code for a controller, and it's a one line option which defines the capability of a controller. It comes with all the machines, and you'll have to start making the NC programming before, immediately after you look into this particular one line code which comes with the controller. So it gives you an idea of the controller capability, and in one line you can also find out what is the sequence in which you have to lay out these different commands, like the N command, the X, Y, Z command, the F command, the miscellaneous command, the speed command, all those things, so that you can have the controller to understand these lines in a certain sequence, in a certain manner that you would like to address. Okay. So in the next module, we will like to take this up in more detail and do some realistic programming upon some parts, so that you understand and get a feel of how you as a programmer can begin your journey into this NC programming world. Thank you so much.